Previously on Minecraft Story Mode.
That glow, that enchantment, is the work of a very old group of builders. A group so old that they existed even before the Order of the Stone.
Okay, guys, I'm seeing grass, forests, lots of ground in all directions. All good signs so far.
Verdict says, definitely not our world. You owe me 2 iron, Lucas. Pay up.
Okay. Here.
Told you it was a dumb bet.
Oh, who asked you?
It's just 2 iron, Lucas. Don't look so disappointed. You're making me feel bad.
No. I was just... I'm just worried about Axel and Olivia.
What? Why?
Well, if they followed us back to that old builder temple and went through the portal...
they would arrive in Sky City to find it overflowing with monsters.
Yeah.
At least we already built them the bridge.
That is more than we started with.
Hey, maybe next time we're in the portal hall, we can leave a sign or something. Tell them which one we're going through.
I like that idea.
Well, I for one vote that we not be so hasty to try and get out of here. Who knows what sorts of treasures this new world could hold. Besides, unless the next portal is disguised as a tombstone, I'm not seeing it anywhere near here.
You guys see some sort of shape over there?
Yeah. What is that?
Let's find out. It says invitation, and then... read immediately, your life depends on it. Ahem. Greetings, traveler.
Yep, that seems about right.
Keep reading, Jesse. We've got your back.
I humbly invite you to my mansion for an evening of food and festivity with your fellow adventurers.
That's odd.
Yeah, weird, right? Wah!
Toss it here!
Petra, any time now? You can read, right?
Hang on. Need to find Jesse's place. Got it.
Come to my home on the hill. Just follow the path.
Please look out for zombies. Sincerely, the host.
Nice warning.
Come on, there's the path.
I must say, this is the highest concentration of zombies I've ever seen in one place.
You think this host is gonna be legit, Jesse? I just ask because this place hasn't exactly been friendly so far.
Boy, I hope so. Wouldn't mind getting out of the zombies for a bit.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say, that's the place we're looking for.
Race you guys there.
Oh, yeah. I don't race so much anymore. Bad knees.
Hope that fighting helped you work up an appetite, Petra. Because you're about to eat my dust.
Oh, big words, Jesse.
Thank you.
You hear that too, right? Almost sounds like a... waterfall!
Okay, you won that one, Jesse.
Let's maybe get inside the mansion before we pat ourselves on the back too much, shall we?
That front door's definitely a no-go. Stick with me, guys! What'd you see? You just gasped, like you'd seen something.
Don't know who he was, some creepy guy in the window. He had a white pumpkin for a head!
White pumpkin? No such thing as white pumpkins!
Let's save the agricultural discussions for inside, okay?
Great! There's no door back here.
How are we supposed to get
in?
In through there. Trees! We can cut those down!
Good plan!
And now my inventory is full of wood blocks.
Hey, you never know when those will come in handy.
Looks like there's some kind of kitchen in there!
Then break the window and get us into the blasted place!
Hope the host doesn't mind us breaking their window.
I'm sure he'll find it in his heart to forgive us.
Wow, some kitchen.
Hot dog, you know I don't care if you took it. Just give it back.
And I'm telling you, for the last time, Sparkles, I didn't take the stupid thing.
I think we could avoid a lot of unpleasantness.
What the?
Hi.
Oh, ha ha ha. Very, very funny. Show up super late, make us all sit and wonder what the heck is going on. This is your house, right? Because if it is, we've all been waiting for like hours. It's rude!
Now, easy, Torque Dog.
Jesse, are you going to take this one, or shall I?
This is Torque Dog.
Sup?
And I'm Captain Sparkles. Though, maybe you know that already. Captain Sparkles, I've got, like... 9 million fans?
Captain Sparkles? Are you saying that with a Z?
Those are your names? Like your real names?
Yes.
Huh. Weird. Anyway, I'm Jesse. That's Petra, Ivor, and Lucas.
Charmed.
Jesse? That's a boy's name. What are you guys anyway? Some sort of loser patrol?
Twerk dog.
Oh, come on. That was hilarious.
Actually, we're the Order of the Stone. Legendary heroes. Kind of a big deal.
Legendary heroes? I ain't never heard of you.
Twerk dog. Cool it. That sea of zombies has us all trapped. So we just need to try our best to get along.
Worst day ever.
All these other people as rude as you.
Watch yourself, little dude. I tell you what, the minute all them weird zombies are gone, Torque Dog is out of here.
Okay, so the sea of zombies isn't normal. Good to hear.
Two moons is normal, though, right?
The moons? Yeah.
Why don't you know about this stuff? You from, like, out of town or something?
What now? Do you hear that?
Somebody touched my foot! Who touched my foot?
I think it's...
Hey! What's going on?
Hey, Jesse. Jesse, come here. You've got... a boy's name.
Twerk dog?
Twerk dog?
So I'm guessing calling dibs on his inventory would be...
That poor guy. That's so awful.
Yeah, he, seemed like a little bit of a jerk. But that's still a nasty way to go.
All those arrows, his inventory, everywhere. How did that... Who? One minute he's alive, the next.
I know. That was absolutely awful. We were talking, like, a second ago, and then suddenly, he's full of arrows. Everyone stand back. Let me see what I can figure out.
This... is... Why is this happening?
Gunpowder, redstone dust, leather pants... Pretty much what you'd expect, I guess.
Who would do this?
There's the trap door that sucked up Twerk Dog's stuff. Looks like it's a matched set with that arrow dispenser up there.
But you saw his stuff. He didn't really have anything worth stealing.
Perhaps it was simply to dispose of the evidence.
This whole thing is getting creepier by the minute.
Guys, found something strange about this arrow. Ivor, you know potions and enchantments and weird stuff like that. What do you make of it?
Smells like... Yes. Potion of poison?
Oh, is it a tipped arrow? Oh, I've heard of those. They're still pretty new. Oh, nasty stuff.
Using potions to make arrows, the possibilities are fascinating.
You say you know about these tipped arrows. Anything else you know that you're not telling us?
Well, you're not implying what I think you're implying, are you? Because I had nothing to do with this. Nothing.
Could have sworn I saw someone doing a tutorial on how to make those not too long ago.
My nerves are too shot to remember who right now.
Well, let me know if it comes back to you.
Hello? Everything okay in here?
Whoa! What's with the crowd?
I was just about to get everyone together to tell them at once.
Okay. Hang on a minute. It's you. I recognize you.
Excuse me?
Yes. What?
Oh, really? Because I've never seen you in my life.
I'll show you. Follow me.
Okay. Lizzie, hi. Did you see all these new... Oh, you've got them with you. Well, first it was the portraits of the people already here, then poof, you guys.
Whoa, that's Unexpected.
Yeah, no kidding.
They're absolutely exquisite. Perfect.
Well, not perfect.
Absolutely perfect.
Must have been when we showed up.
This is so ridiculously creepy.
Right? At first I was like, oh, cool, fan art, flattering. But the more I thought about it, creepy is definitely right.
Well, that's definitely not a good sign.
Come on, everyone. Let's huddle up
in the dining room.
Wonder if he told them yet.
Can't wait to hear the big news.
Me neither.
Ooh, I hope there's cake.
Guess not.
Come on, let's do this.
Come on, Winslow.
Here, let me introduce you all properly. You guys already met Cassie Rose and LD Shadow Lady.
But my friends call me Lizzie.
This is Stacy Plays, Stampy Cat, and that's Dan, the Diamond Minecart.
When did your hair change color? Wasn't it?
It's funny. Before you guys showed up, we all knew each other here. They're the Order of the Stone. Jesse, Petra, Lucas, and Ivor. Apparently, they're famous heroes where they come from.
You said there was news? Is it good? Good news?
Yeah. It's, bad news, I'm afraid. Torque Dog is dead.
Good heavens!
Oh, no!
Wait, what?
But Torque Dog was so tough! There was nothing that could take him down. What happened?
Yeah, what on earth is going on here, Sparkles?
I was there. It was a terrible accident.
An accident? Oh my!
Oh, come on, Stampy. Don't be so gullible. Must have been quite the accident to take out Torque Dog. I can't believe Torque Dog's gone. Just like that.
So, what happened to his stuff?
Whoa! How can you say that?
What? It's a valid question.
Whoa.
His stuff just disappeared. Went down this weird hole in the floor.
Are we just supposed to take your word for that?
Guys, I saw it too. Jesse was poking around in Torque Dog's stuff right before it got sucked into a hopper.
So I'm looking at this situation, I'm trying to figure something out. Is this just about Torque Dog, or is there a bigger picture?
Yeah, why have our portraits?
I don't know, guys. Knowing Torque Dog, I think this might just be about him.
Am I picking up some beef here?
Okay, but then why invite us all here?
That's true. Hadn't thought about that. Well, someone brought us here for a reason, including Torque Dog.
What if we're all in danger?
Oh my gosh! Dan's right!
Whoever's doing this, they could be hunting us!
Hey, I don't know what kind of danger you guys are wrapped up in, but we just met you, so... I'm thinking this isn't my problem.
Well, we're all stuck in this house now, so it kinda is your problem too?
Oh, all of this danger talk has my stomach all queasy.
Stampy, come over here. I need to talk to you about something.
Lizzie, psst. Lizzie.
The more I think about it, the more I think that there's something these people really don't want us to know.
One of them's gotta know the truth about what's going on here.
Sounds like we've got a mystery to solve, people. Luckily, Detective Jesse is on the case. Hey, Sparkles. And Cassie Rose, yeah?
Yep, hi. That's me.
Hey there, Jesse.
Oh, Winslow says hi, too.
You mind if I ask you guys some questions?
Nope. What are the questions?
Stick around.
Okay.
You got it.
Stick around.
Okay.
You got it.
Hey, guys.
Oh, hello. Got more questions, do you?
Don't go anywhere. Hey, guys.
Hey, Jesse. How's it going?
Yeah, find anything out yet why Torque Dog was... you know.
I'm going to keep asking around about Torque Dog.
Good luck.
Yes. Happy investigating.
Hey, guys.
Oh, hello. Got more questions, do you?
Lizzie, seems like you're not much of a Torque Dog fan. What's the deal?
Oh, come on. You met him, right? Nobody liked that guy. I'm just the only one who will actually admit it.
He definitely wasn't the nicest person.
Don't go anywhere. Hey, guys. Stampy and Stacy, right?
Hello!
Hey, Jesse. What's up?
I know things are a little nuts right now, but I've got some questions.
Oh, really? What?
Thanks. I'll be back.
We, look forward to it?
Hey, guys.
How goes the investigation?
I'm going to keep asking around about Torque Dog.
Good luck.
Yes. Happy investigating.
Hey, guys.
How goes the investigation?
You guys have any theories about what's going on?
I don't trust any of them. I think they could all be in on it together.
Oh, surprise. Ivor's feeling paranoid.
Have you talked to a cat guy and Stacy yet? I don't like the way they're all huddled up.
Good tip. I'm going to keep asking around about Torque Dog.
Good luck.
Yes. Happy investigating.
Stick around.
Okay.
You got it.
There was drama between Lizzie and Torque Dog, right? Got any insight?
Sorry, I'm not getting wrapped up in that. Especially now that Torque Dog is, you know...
But it's weird, right?
definitely seems like there's some beef. Not that I, want to get into rumors or anything like that.
Cassie, you seemed pretty upset about people wanting to poke around Torque Dog's inventory.
Oh, was I?
Yeah, you were. Why was that?
Well, it was just so... it's insensitive, right? I mean, it had just happened, and she was all curious about what was in his pockets. Just made me mad, I guess.
Got any guesses why someone would kill Torque Dog?
Gosh. He was a little prickly around the edges, you know? You'd have to ask other people about that. I didn't really know him.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to say anything mean about a guy that's not here to defend himself, but, well, you met him, right? Prickly is kind of an understatement.
Sparkles, Cassie, Winslow. Thanks for the time.
No problem.
Yeah, anytime.
Get anything out of them?
Found out this group has a whole lot of secrets they're keeping from each other.
That's definitely something.
Hey, guys.
Oh, hello. Got more questions, do you?
It seemed like people were really interested in seeing Torque Dog's inventory. Any idea why?
An adventurer like him? He could have had all kinds of cool stuff.
Uh-huh. Torque Dog was clearly targeted with this trap. Why him?
Well, he was bragging about having some kind of rare item.
Wouldn't show it to anyone, of course. Typical Torque Dog.
So, this rare item that Torque Dog claimed to have, what can you tell me about it?
We don't know exactly.
Yeah, sorry.
Okay, that's it for now. Thanks.
What'd you find out?
It's all tangled up, but it sounds like Torque Dog claimed to have some sort of rare item.
I didn't see anything like that in his inventory, though.
Yeah, something's not quite adding up here. Hey, you two.
What's up?
Stacy, you seemed pretty curious about what was in Torque Dog's inventory. What's up with that?
Well, Torque Dog was a pretty notorious thief. I was just curious what he had. That's it.
Mm-hmm. Seems like Lizzie and Torque Dog really didn't like each other. Know anything else about that?
Oh, that! Real shame.
He broke into her house and stole a bunch of stuff from her. She was super upset about it.
You don't say. Anyone you can think of that would want something bad to happen to Torque Dog?
Well, I never had that big of a problem with him personally. But I know other people did. Quite a few, actually. I don't know if you noticed, but he was a bit of a griefer.
Yeah, and a thief.
Thief, huh? Interesting. Thanks, you two. This has been enlightening.
No problem.
Yeah, no problem.
So did you find anything out from Stacy or Sturdy Cat?
Stampy Cat?
Right. So did you find anything out?
Apparently, Torque Dog was a well-known thief.
A thief, huh? Well, that might have something to do with it, don't you think?
Agreed. So, Torque Dog was a thief, and he supposedly had something rare. But It feels like there's still a piece missing. No one will tell me what this rare item is.
I think I can shed some light on that situation, actually.
Well, now my curiosity is piqued.
He already had me at rare item.
Of course he did. There's a temple, way out in the middle of nowhere. No one knows who built it, but it's been there forever. People have been trying to track down the temple's location for ages because they want this treasure. It's supposedly deep in its basement. Now, it looks just like an ordinary flint and steel, but it's actually super rare. It's got this enchantment on it.
It can open portals to other worlds.
Exactly. Wait, what? You know about the enchanted flint and steel? How did you know that? Have you seen it? Have you seen it today?
Sorry, we don't know anything about this. What was it? Flint and steel? Sorry.
Not to be cynical, but I'm not sure I believe you. But I do think I'm starting to figure out why we're all here. Everyone? Everyone? Whoever killed Torque Dog, whoever invited us, they're after the enchanted flint and steel.
Ah! Sparkle?
Panic, Sparkles!
Someone find the lights, quick!
Greetings, adventurers. I am the White Pumpkin. One of you has the treasure I desire, and I will not rest until it is mine, even if I have to resort to murder.
More panicking, more panicking!
White Pumpkin! Too cute to die!
They killed Sparkles!
No, this gotta be, what's going on? No!
Whoa, hang on!
This is awful! Terrible! Who was that guy?
And there's no such thing as white pumpkins!
Tell that to all of the white pumpkins hanging all over the place!
I don't like it! I really don't like it!
I actually saw him in the window when we first got here.
You mean he's been in here the whole time? I'm so getting out of here.
So much for a nice dinner party.
Oh, no!
I don't like the sound of that.
Oh! Shut the door! Shut the door!
Scared. So we're stuck in here. And if we're stuck in here, we're all doomed.
I thought I heard Sparkle say something about a flint and steel.
Oh, please don't bring that up again.
Well, obviously, Talk Dog didn't steal it.
Okay, but who then?
Jesse?
Well, I guess I'm next, then.
Nope, not happening. I am not letting that guy take down anyone else.
It's a good thought, Petra. But this white pumpkin is doing things I can't explain, and that scares me!
Well, I'm sure there's a perfectly logical explanation for how the white pumpkin is doing all this. I mean, the whole place has got to be rigged with traps, right? Torque Dog, trap. Sparkles. Trap.
Yeah. We need to find out what makes these traps tick. All right. I'm going to investigate that dining room.
Cool. I'll keep those guys in the hall for now so I can keep an eye on everyone.
An excellent idea. Don't want them messing up the crime scene.
I'm sticking with you, Jesse. Doesn't seem safe to wander off alone.
Okay, people, clear out! This is a crime scene!
Okay. How are you doing this, White Pumpkin? Okay, so this was the dining table where we were all gathered together right before... How you holding up?
You mean after seeing a guy get crushed under a ton of sand? Yeah, I'm definitely a little shaken up. We need to figure out who's doing this. And how.
Well, keep your eyes open. Between the two of us, I'm sure we'll be able to figure it out.
Sounds good to me.
Okay, let's give this a shot.
Just like before.
Greetings, adventurers. I am the White Pumpkin.
Yep.
One of you
just like
is
before.
The treasure I desire, and I will not rest until it is mine, even if I have to resort to murder.
It's just... a costume on an armor stand with a jukebox for a voice. No sign of how it was triggered.
Wow. The White Pumpkin must have some amazing redstone skills to rig up something like this. But why? Must have taken a lot of work to rig up. They must have a reason for it. Well, hopefully something else in here can shed a little more light on the situation.
Jesse!
He's back! The White Pumpkin's back!
Don't worry, everyone. It's just a dummy. A White Pumpkin costume on an armor stand.
Wait, what? Why?
The trap that killed Sparkles. The whole show with the White Pumpkin. It was all triggered by a button on the table.
But what does that mean?
I am so creeped out right now.
It means that we can figure out the White Pumpkin's identity. Whoever had access to the button must be him.
Wait, so you're saying that the White Pumpkin is one of us?
That's right, Mr. Stampy. One of us is a murderer.
And he sat right here.
Wait, but that's not where Jesse found the button before.
There's more than one?
I'll see if I can find all of them.
Nice work, Jesse.
Yes, I must say I'm relieved to know that there's a logical explanation for what the White Pumpkin's been doing.
So what now? Feels like we've made some good progress so far, though, right?
We need to figure out the most likely suspects and interrogate them. Judging by the tipped arrows and these traps, the White Pumpkin must have some serious chops in brewing and redstone.
Okay, that's all of them.
If you could all please take the same seat you were at before. Four of your seats are marked. These are the seats that had a button to activate the trap. That means that the White Pumpkin could only be Dan, Stampy, Lizzie, or Lucas.
Wait, you're accusing us? Wait, what?
I echo their sentiments exactly. I didn't even see a button.
Me neither.
This is crazy.
The evidence is rather incriminating.
Yeah, well, your face is incriminating.
I'm taking charge now. And I'm going to get to the bottom of this. I want everyone separated. I'm going to talk to each suspect one by one so I can find out who's telling the truth and who's lying. I've got a whole lot of questions, and I want nice little matching answers for each and every one of them. Understand me?
Loud and clear.
Yes, crystal clear.
Who are you going to interrogate first?
Stampy Cat.
Jesse, I'm telling you, this is just crazy! Absolutely crazy! Total misunderstanding! I don't even want that flint and steel thingy. Not as much as the others, at any rate. Did I hear someone saying that it has something to do with portals? I don't have any interest in portals. No, sir. Not for old Mr. Stumpy Cat, thank you. It's me, Stumpy! Everyone's friend!
Ah, come on now, Mr. Stumpy. I thought you were some legendary adventurer. You want me to believe that you don't want an ancient artifact that lets you travel to different worlds?
Ooh, I mean, that does sound tempting, but, no, thank you. I'm fine with my local legend status. I'm a man of simple pleasures. Please, just tell me what you want to know.
Okay, enough dancing around. Who do you think took the flint and steel?
I don't think it was ever actually stolen.
Oh?
Yeah, so Dan got it ahead of Lizzie, right? And she was pretty angry about it. I think he made up that story about it being stolen so she'd think he didn't have it anymore. Classic Dan move.
What do you know about redstone? What's your skill level with the stuff?
Oh, well, you know, about average? Average level? Moderate? I don't know how these things are graded these days. I know that Dan's been getting really into the stuff lately, though. Just putting that out there, in case you're curious.
Dan's interested in redstone, huh? Know anything about this?
Oh, wow! What is that? Some sort of magic arrow? No, I've never seen anything like it before. Honest. You know who would love to see something like that, though? Lizzie. She's wild about potions and brewing and all of that. She's way better with that stuff than I am.
Good with potions, you say?
Very good. Could probably even teach a class.
You're excused, Stampy. Thank you for your time.
Oh, thank goodness. This room's making me very nervous.
Who's up next?
Can you send in Dan, please?
Right.
Hey, I don't know what Stampy told you, but... I'm telling you, you've got the wrong guy. Honest, I would never hurt anyone. You've got to believe me. If anyone's been wronged here, it's me. That enchanted flint and steel everyone's talking about, I found that. That's mine. At least it was before someone stole it. And now everything's gone completely crazy. People getting caught in horrible traps, everyone accusing and blaming each other. I just can't believe this is all over my enchanted flint and steel. I'm not the White Pumpkin. You've got to believe me. What can I tell you to convince you?
Know anything about this?
Oh, wow. No, I've never seen anything like that before.
No? Tipped arrows not ringing a bell? Made using potions.
Nuh-uh, but you want to know about stuff with potions? I've asked Lizzie. She's way better with that stuff than I am.
So, how would you rate your redstone knowledge?
Me? Oof, not much. Not really my scene. You want to know more about that stuff? You should ask Stampy. He was the Triblock champion.
Weird. Stampy said that you were pretty into redstone.
What? No, he's got me confused with someone else. I'm sure of it. Now, Lizzie, though, I've seen her do some amazing things with redstone. Between you and me, I wouldn't be surprised if she was the one behind all of this.
Out with it! Who stole the flint and steel?
Oh, well, Lizzie, obviously. She was jealous. Never got over the fact that I found it first.
You can go now, Dan.
Thanks, Jesse. Thank you. And when you talk to Lizzie, don't forget to ask her about those crazy magic arrows. I bet she'll know something.
Want me to send in Lizzie?
That'd be great. Thanks, Petra.
Jesse, listen. There's been a lot of talk thrown around today. I don't know what people have told you. I don't know what you believe. But I'll just admit it. I want that enchanted flint and steel as much as anyone. Probably more than any of them. I've been searching for it for years. Do you know how much it stung to have Dan, swoop in and take it from under my nose?
Oh, and so that's why you invited everyone here, huh? To find out who stole it.
I wouldn't waste my time in all these white pumpkin games. Listen, I just want to get out of here and get on with my day. What do you have to hear to be convinced that the white pumpkin isn't me?
I'm just gonna be straight. Who do you think stole the flint and steel?
Well, it wasn't me, if you're curious. If I had an enchanted flint and steel, I'd be off exploring some other world with it. Between you and me, though, I think Dan's whole story about it being stolen from him is a load of trash. I bet he's still got it.
You like using redstone? Ever make traps with the stuff?
I'm fine, I guess. I can make lights and doors and stuff. You want to do advanced stuff? You gotta talk to Stampy. He was the tri-block champion.
So I've heard. Know what this is?
Tipped arrow. Kinda shoddy work, though. Definitely not one of mine, if that's what you're wondering. Some noob made that thing. What? Yeah, I knew what a tipped arrow was. I'm a good brewer. Doesn't mean it's mine. I taught Cassie and Stacy how to make those ages ago.
No, because everyone else seems to think otherwise.
What? What are you talking about?
Yeah? Everyone I ask says that you're the only one with the skills here to make something like this.
Okay, sure. Of the people here, maybe. Doesn't make me the white pumpkin, though. And I'm not sure I like you implying otherwise.
Thanks for your time, Lizzie. That's all for now.
Oh, come on! This is nuts!
You had a button, too! Fair's fair. It's your buddy's turn next.
Hey, Jesse.
My final suspect. Here to point more fingers and blame more people, I'm sure.
I didn't push the button, you know.
I figured. Thanks, though.
How's it been going in here? It is just non-stop whispering and rumors out there. Me, Petra, and Ivor pretty much been sticking to ourselves. Yeah. Seems like a pretty complicated case. Well, if there's one person who can untangle it, it's you.
Come on, suspect. It's time to return to the others.
So? Have you decided?
Yes. Who do you think the white pumpkin really is?
Now, hang on, everyone. First of all, I want to thank everyone for answering my questions. There's still not 100% proof of anyone, but...
But?
Yes. Where are your suspicions leading, Jesse?
Jesse was definitely questioning Stampy the longest.
What? No!
Dan was in there way longer.
Hey, not cool.
Guys, come on.
Having gone through all the evidence, right now I'm leaning towards Dan!
Whoa. Are you serious? Are you really serious right
There's
now?
There's just way too much drama around Dan wanting his flint and steel back. It's pretty suspicious.
Guys, you're not really listening to this, are you?
I say we lock him up in the library. Figure out what to do with him in the morning.
I fully endorse this plan.
Sorry, Dan, but we can't take any chances
here.
No,
this is nuts. I'm not the white pumpkin. Aren't you hearing how crazy that sounds?
Well, that was certainly some excitement.
Yeah, no kidding.
If the white pumpkin is still roaming around, though, he might be trying to set up more traps. We need to figure out how these things work. Like, we know that the Sparkles trap was triggered by those buttons under the table, but what about the trap that turned Torque Dog into a pincushion? If we figure out how these things work, we might be able to find more proof about who the White Pumpkin is, how they're operating.
I'm not sure, but the White Pumpkin didn't trigger it until Torque Dog was in the exact right spot. That means he must have been watching from somewhere.
Creepy.
Yes. Seems like it might be worth our while to poke around the kitchen.
You guys go on ahead. I'm gonna stay here, keep an eye on these other people. I don't want them trying anything when we're not looking.
Thanks, Lucas.
Back in the kitchen. So, what are we looking for exactly? Buttons like back in the dining room? conspicuous white pumpkins lying around. Okay, then. I'll just keep my eyes peeled for anything white pumpkin-y.
Nice plan.
Give me a moment. I'm trying to figure this one out myself.
What happened, Lucas? I thought you were chasing the white pumpkin.
Yeah, I was. And I almost had him until, he took me by surprise and stuffed this pumpkin on my head.
What's going on in here?
No!
You called the white pumpkin! Grab him, quick!
On it!
Get out of our way, Jesse.
Yeah, it's all out in the open now. You can't defend your friend anymore.
But Dan was the one who pushed the button that killed Sparkles in the first place.
It doesn't match up. You were there when the white pumpkin did that to Lizzie, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was. So that means I can't be the white pumpkin.
It's the facts, Jesse. These horrible things only started happening when your group arrived. And now Lizzie is gone too.
I say we throw him outside and let nature take its course.
What? Outside?
Where all the googlies are?
No, you can't do that.
Yeah, I don't know. I still have my suspicions about Lucas, but Jesse did save me. And you tried to save Lizzie. I don't feel right about chucking your friend to the zombies.
Brave stance. Thank you. See? You all heard Dan, right?
Fine.
Thank you.
Don't go celebrating yet. We've still got to do something with you so you're not roaming around freely.
What? Like lock me up in a closet or something?
There was a closet in the main hall with a lovely metal door. Seems like a perfect place to lock someone up.
Wait, I was mostly joking.
I guess that's fair. But I'm keeping guard because I still don't trust him. That cool with everyone?
That's not happening unless one of us goes along, too.
It's fine, Jesse. I'll watch over Lucas.
Awesome.
Come on, Cassie. But don't go getting any funny ideas, blonde guy. This isn't because I like you or anything.
No, of course not.
Be quiet. Prisoners aren't supposed to talk. Okay, well, what are we supposed to do now? We need to figure out how we're going to clear Lucas's name. And I'd like to do it sooner rather than later. Seems like some of these people are getting a little stir-crazy.
Somehow the white pumpkin was able to escape that room when Lucas chased him into it. We need to figure out how he did that.
Sounds like a plan to me.
Dan, I know that you're innocent, but you're still a suspect, Stampy Cat. Got some questions.
Seriously?
Where were you when the chase with the white pumpkin was going on?
I don't want to say.
Aw, oh, come on, Stampy. You're just making yourself look more guilty. Where were you?
Fine. I was sitting in a corner, humming to myself. It calms me down.
Uh-huh. Okay, I'll leave you guys to it.
Uh-huh.
Sounds good.
What do you want?
You've been pretty aggro on accusing Lucas. Seems a little suspicious.
Not nearly as suspicious as Lucas.
Where were you when I was chasing the white pumpkin?
Making cookies. I get a sweet tooth when I'm nervous.
Don't go anywhere, Stacy.
Sure.
How are things with you?
Oh, you know, just peachy. Stuck in a house with a masked killer. One of my best friends is the current top suspect. It was really nice of Ivor to step up like that, though. Didn't think he had it in him.
Yeah, that guy can still surprise me sometimes.
Agreed. I think there's a lot more there than meets the eye. Okay, well, I vote we get back to it. Don't want to leave poor Lucas in that closet for too long.
Secret passage. Well, this looks promising. I wonder what order these need to be in. Yeah, that seems right. Okay, that seems like a step in the right direction. There we go. Awesome.
Oh, wow! You got it open!
Yeah, you guys should stay here. It could be dangerous.
No, I totally want to follow you into your friend's creepy secret passageways.
Seriously? You really think Lucas did it?
You haven't proven that he didn't yet.
Hey, come on, cool it. We're all in this together, aren't we?
Depends. Figured you'd be on your little buddy's side.
Ugh. You know what? They're not worth it. Come on.
Wow, that is deep. Guess it leads down to whatever the White Pumpkin calls home. I wonder how he gets down there.
Maybe in addition to walking through walls, he can fly for all we know. Ugh! It's just... I'm really worried about Lucas. Those people think they're all safe, but the White Pumpkin is still running around, and he could strike again at any minute. Not to mention, all those people back there have been so ungrateful, so petty.
Petra, I get that you're upset, but would you stop taking it out on me? I'm trying here.
Okay. I'm really sorry.
We're gonna get through this. Let's start by... figuring out how we're gonna get down there, huh? You know the drill. What have you got in your inventory? Didn't you have all those wood blocks?
Sorry, I was whittling earlier. Nervous habit.
Well, luckily those should do just the trick.
You thinking ladder?
Yeah.
Gonna need a lot of them.
I'll race you.
You're on.
Done.
Don't. Oh, man. Thanks. I needed that.
All right, we got a lot more of these to make.
Let's get to work.
Okay, that's one down.
Lots more to go.
See? Told you we'd make it.
Yeah. I just hope this works. You think we're gonna find the White Pumpkin down here? all these secret passageways?
Why, you scared?
No, of course not. Just making sure I'm ready in case we have to fight.
Hey, do you hear?
Lots and lots of zombies? Yeah, I do. I'm starting to smell them, too.
Ugh, ditto. Gross.
Well, that explains all the zombie noises.
Some sort of, like, zombie spawner.
Does that mean the white pumpkin actually made the sea of zombies outside?
That's what it looks like.
What's that?
I think this is where people's stuff goes after those hoppers upstairs suck it up.
You're right. I think that's Lizzie's. Okay, but where's the loot going from here?
Hopefully right to the white pumpkin. Hey, you see the light coming out of that tunnel too, right?
Huh? Oh, yeah. And it doesn't look like it's blocked off like all the, zombie-filled ones.
We can get up there. I think we might be able to follow the loot to wherever it's going.
Well, that's awesome. Nice find. How do you want to get up there?
Grab some dirt, Petro. We're going climbing.
Okay, I think we can jump from here. Almost embarrassing. Thanks, Jesse.
No problem. Weird. That almost sounds like...
cats? Sort of growing station. Weird.
The white pumpkin must have heard us.
What? Ah!
Stampy cat?
Boy, you gave me a fright. What are you doing down here?
What are we doing down here?
Yes, it looks terribly suspicious, you know.
Scared you? You scared us half to death. Stop sneaking around like that.
I'm sorry. I don't know if you noticed, but this place is very creepy. Come on, you guys. I can't be the white pumpkin. I'm Stampy Cat. I'm no murderer. Huh? I needed to find you because I have something important to tell you. I have something to confess. Something I haven't told anyone.
Where is this going?
I stole it from Dan. It was just supposed to be a joke, a harmless prank, but then, well, you've seen what happened.
Wow. Who'd have thought?
I knew people wanted it, but I had no idea that this would happen.
Wow. Stampy Cat with the enchanted flint and steel. I didn't see that one coming.
Definitely suspicious.
I know, and that's why I had to keep it a secret. I may be a thief, but I'm no killer. But that white pumpkin is, and he's killing people for it. And now we're down in his lair. I was thinking maybe I should just give it to the white pumpkin.
What?
Just maybe that would make it all stop, right? Maybe?
I think you should give it back to Dan. It's only fair.
Yeah, you're right. That's better.
That looks like a lair door, if I ever saw one.
Oh, wow.
Very creepy.
I would not put this in my top 10 places I've ever been.
Well, there's where the meowing's coming from.
Don't worry, we'll get out of here as soon as we find something that proves the White Pumpkin's identity. Let's see here, Legend of the World, Portals, Basic Portal Theory, Portals and You. Wow, they're all about portals, that's pretty obsessive.
Petra, did you see this?
That's the portal hallway.
Yeah, it looks like the White Pumpkin's been there too. Oh no.
Here's where everyone's stuff gets collected.
Those poor people.
You guys doing okay?
I'll be honest with you. I'm pretty worried about Lucas. If the White Pumpkin isn't down here, he must still be upstairs.
And I thought that I was okay because I was numb and feeling no emotions at all. But I'm beginning to suspect it was actually shock.
Don't worry, we're gonna crack this wide open. I'm guessing this chest should have... Oh, yep, we've got sticks.
Anything else?
Oh, wow, and ender pearls. Sweet, that must be how the White Pumpkin got down that elevator shaft. Looks like a typical brewing stand. Must be where the White Pumpkin made the tipped arrows that killed Torque Dog. Didn't Lizzie say that she taught Cassie and Stacy how to make those too?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, she did.
Should be able to get some string from those cobwebs. It'll go perfectly with those sticks I found. That chest definitely seems important. Okay, kitty kitty, can you scoot out of the way, please? I need to get in the chest. No! Bad kitty! Oh, stupid cats. I need something to distract it if I'm gonna get that chest open. Yeah, now just to figure out where I can catch one. Ah!
Wow, nice catch, Jesse.
Thanks! Bet that cat'll love this. Okay, here, kitty. Get the fishy. There you go. Jeez. Ah, many cats. So many cats.
Ugh, cats give me the creeps. No offense, Stampy.
None taken. I'm not really a cat.
Guess I can finally get in here now. It's full of portraits. Loads of them.
I don't like that. I guess he already had all the X'd out ones ready to go.
Yep, besides Petra, we've got Dan, Stacy, Stampy, Lucas, Ivor, and... Oh, hey, there's me.
But what does it all mean? The cats? The crossed out portraits?
Yeah, the portraits. There was one person who didn't have a crossed out portrait.
someone who's a known cat person.
Okay, so who did it?
Yes, you figured it out?
The White Pumpkin is Cassie Rose. She's the murderer.
Oh, man. You're totally right.
I don't believe it!
Not only is she the White Pumpkin, but she owns way, way too many cats.
Well, come on, you guys. It's time to prove Lucas's innocence and catch us a White Pumpkin.
I'll go round everyone up.
What's going on?
Yeah, you were gone an awful long time. What's going on here?
Did you even find anything?
Quickly, where's Cassie Rose?
Cassie? Why do you ask?
Yeah, what's up?
No sign of Cassie, but...
Huh? Are you gonna tell them, or should I just do it?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Jesse, go on.
The White Pumpkin is Cassie Rose. She's the murderer.
That's impossible. No way. No way.
Yeah, Jesse, I'm afraid you're gonna have to do better than that. Look at the facts. We caught Lucas with that pumpkin head right after poor Lizzie got taken out. I think you're just lying to protect him.
Cassie's making a lot of sense right now. Do you have any evidence to back you up?
There's something that's been bothering me for a while now. Something that happened in the Great Hall shortly after Torque Dog was hit with that trap.
What's that?
Go on, Jesse. You've got this.
Where is this going?
Shh. Let Jesse finish.
Ivor's portrait had a red X on it.
Actually, no, it didn't, Jesse.
Oh, shoot, I guess I misremembered that. Well, no matter. I haven't even gotten to the really juicy stuff yet. That came next. When we were down in the basement, we found some very interesting items. Items for the White Pumpkin's evening festivities. And there was one very significant detail.
What was this evidence?
The White Pumpkin had portraits all ready to go, pre-X'd out, one for each of us, except for Cassie.
Ooh, that's good.
Okay, I think they're on the fence, but you can do this. Bring it home, okay?
But it was the last piece of evidence, dear friends, that helped me really figure out who we were dealing with here. Cats. Dozens of calico cats, and they all look just like Winslow.
An amusing story, Jesse. But if you saw all these supposed cats just like mine, then what color is Winslow? It shouldn't be a problem if you saw 100.
Cats? Really?
Shh. Winslow is black, white, and orange.
Cassie, is this all true?
This whole thing has been about your crazy scheme to get a portal key, hasn't it? Killing whoever gets in your way.
How very clever, Jesse. Well, I guess that's it then. You caught me. I am the murderer.
I just don't believe this.
I know. I was shocked too.
I'm relieved, but also surprised.
But Cassie, I still don't understand why a portal key.
I've been stuck in this stupid world with its stupid two moons for years. Trapped with a portal right under my nose, but no key to open it. That is, until I finally heard that this world's portal key had been found. I knew it was one of you. So I tried my best to earn your friendship, figure out who had it.
Cassie, how could you? We shared cookies together. Cookies!
You really think that's an excuse? You're pathetic, Cassie. It doesn't excuse all the horrible things you've done.
Spoken just like a person who has no idea what it feels like to be stuck somewhere you don't belong.
We need to do something with you, Cassie Rose.
I vote we build an obsidian prison and surround it with love.
No, I won't let you do that. I can't. No! This is your fault! You did this to me! I'll fight all of you! Each and every one of you!
Whoa! Another trap! We need
one she's hurt? She can dig herself out.
She did terrible things, but no one deserves this!
Yeah! Yeah! Wait! Look! I can't believe it! She's gone!
What a way to go!
Yeah, I guess in all the chaos, she forgot where her own traps were. Wow.
Wow. The trapper taken out by one of her own traps. That's ironic.
If only she had just asked us for help, we could have avoided this whole thing.
Hey, it's morning.
I guess that's it then.
Yeah, we're free.
And we're alive! Let's not waste it standing around. There could still be traps everywhere in here!
Ah, I've never been so happy to smell rotting flesh.
Yeah, that is... yikes, that is pretty rank.
I feel bad thinking about the people who aren't here to smell it. Talk Dog, Sparkles, Lizzie, and Cassie, I guess.
That's a good point.
Yeah, I didn't mean to depress anyone. I just can't stop thinking about them.
It is really sad that they're gone, but I think they'd be happy that you guys made it out okay.
I think you're right.
Lucky for us, that portal brought you here.
Speaking of which, I have no idea how to begin finding our exit portal.
Well, Cassie said it was right under her nose, right?
That's true. Maybe it's nearby. Hey, what do you know? There it is.
A fabulous coincidence!
So, I guess this is goodbye, huh?
Yeah. Just let us know if you ever accidentally find yourselves in our world.
That's really nice of you, but I don't think we can really portal hop without a portal key.
Oh, well, I think Stampy's got you covered there.
You stole the portal key from me?
It was just meant to be a prank, a harmless prank, and I'm so sorry, so very, very sorry.
Yeah, come on, it's Stampy. You know he would never actually try to hurt anyone.
Hey, it's cool. Guys, you can share it. You make, like, your own Order of the Stone.
Yeah, all right. I guess I can live with that.
Yes, that's a wonderful idea!
Well, I'm not great at goodbyes, so I'm actually just gonna start walking home. Thanks for everything.
Yeah, me too. Travel safe, you guys.
Bye!
What a strange, strange bunch of individuals. Cassie, what's-her-name, was talking about being trapped here, from another world. What if she was one of the old builders?
Portal keys, other worlds... it all adds up, I guess.
Man, that's too bad if it's true, seeing as she turned out to be, you know, the white pumpkin and all.
Yes. Hadn't thought about that.
I just can't believe that we finally met someone who might be an old builder, and she's a pumpkin-wearing serial killer. Typical.
Well, here we are. Would you care to do the honors, Jesse?
Huh? That's weird. Winslow?
That's strange. I thought... No!
Can't see a thing.
Well, that's ominous.
Do you hear that?
Endermites!
And there it is, Jesse! You're trapped. Stuck. Just like I've been in this rotten world.
Oh, please. I've gotten out of way worse than this, Cassie.
Huh.
I admire your bravado. I don't know how much time you've spent with endermites, but the poor things are eternally hungry. I would throw the flint and steel up here before I drop you down to find out how sharp their teeth are.
Guys, I dropped the flint and steel when we fell. I have no idea where it went.
Tick-tock, Jesse! What's it gonna be? The flint and steel? Or your lives? Just give me the flint and steel, and I'll let you go free.
I don't believe her.
Okay, you're right. You win. We'll give you the flint and steel, but let us out first.
No, I'm not falling for that one. Nope, this is taking too long. I'll just let the endermites eat you and fish it out of your inventory.
It'll be the best fishing trip ever! Winslow, my pet, activate the trap! Want something done right, Captain? Prepare for your death!
Guys!
Jesse!
Come on, Winslow!
Stupid door?
Ugh, it's no use! Without a lever or button, we'll never get these iron doors open!
Just hold on, guys, I'm gonna get up to the control panel! Oh, that is disorienting.
Just started going faster.
She booby-trapped her booby-traps? That is so paranoid.
What? You thought you could do it just like that? Trying to get leverage? Give me that key, Jesse.
Guys, no! No!
Hey, Jesse!
Guys, holy crap, you're all alive, thank goodness.
Yeah, for now.
Don't worry, I found a lever.
Throw it down.
Okay, get ready.
Got it.
Okay, you guys get to safety. I need to find that flint and steel.
You're not a fast learner, are you? I grow tired of this game, Jesse. The key. You didn't have it either. Oh no, it's mine.
Nope. No! No, we are going home.
No! You can't do this! I've waited too long!
Mine! Cassie, I won't let you have it!
No! No, Winslow! Don't touch that! No, Winslow! Bad kitty! Stop it! Winslow! Good boy! Sweet kitty! Bring that to Master! Please, bring it to Master!
Don't listen to the white pumpkin, Winslow. Bring the shiny thing to me!
No!
No!
Ah, there you are! After all this time, I am free! Winslow, we have to go. What have I told you about wandering off?
I think you should give that back, Cassie.
No, I'm afraid not. I'll give you one thing. You are incredibly tenacious. That's never back, Jesse. It stays on fire forever! Well, Winslow, that's the last of the obstacles. We're finally going home! Come on, Winslow! Winslow, come on! Oh, for the love of... You know I love you, but you look very tired sometimes.
Hey, cats suck!
What did you say?
You heard me, cats suck!
up. Things are way cooler.
I don't know what you're playing at, but I'm bored with it.
What's going...
Ah! I've got it! Excellent! I did it!
You're all dying now!
No, thank you!
Got it!
No!
Bet you're real proud of yourself. Look at me! Stuck again! Out of Enderpearls!
And that's where she wanted us to end up!
Trapped. In my own trap! Of course. Of course.
Well, at least you're still alive. That's more than Torque Dog or Captain Sparkles or Lizzie can say.
You're right. Of course you're right. Wait! At least don't leave me here all alone! Give me my cat. My dear, sweet Winslow. He's my best... my only friend. Please. Winslow? Winslow! Where are you, my darling? Come to Master, please! I have a fish! Come get the fishy! Winslow! Winslow!
Wow, so she kept the real portal hidden down here all this time.
Unless this one is a trap, too.
I don't know if even she'd be that paranoid.
Only one way to find out.
Good sign so far.
Yeah, no trick floors or arrows or anything.
Okay, sure. But who's going first?
We're a team, we all go together. Ready? One,
two, three.
Adventure!